I hope you are all doing good. In this video lecture itself, we will discuss about the specification, selection and types of grinding process. Okay, now before starting the grinding process, we have to get knowledge about the abrasive machining, because grinding is the one of the major type of abrasive machining. So what is abrasive machining? So material removal by the action of hard abrasive particle, usually in a form of a bonded beam. Grinding is the most important abrasive machining. Cutting occurs at either the periphery or the face of a grinding wheel. Cutting occurs by the abrasive grinds that are much smaller, numerous and random, self-sharpening as each abrasive falls off. Generally, a finishing operation achieving a surface finish up to 0.025 microns and an extremely close tolerance. So, we can able to achieve the surface finish up to 0.25 microns. That is the specialty of abrasive machining. So what is grinding? Another material removal process in which abrasive particles are contained in a bonded grinding wheel that operates at very high surface speed. The grinding wheel is usually in the disc shaped and it's precisely balanced for the high rotational speeds. Grinding may be classified as the two different categories based on the purpose and procedure. The first one is the non-precision grinding and second one is the precision grinding. So the name itself clearly defines the answer, non-precision grinding. So it doesn't give the more priority to the surface finish. So the common forms are called snagging and offhand grinding. Both are done primarily to remove the stack that cannot be taken off the conveniently by the other methods. The work is pressed hard against the wheel or vice versa. The accuracy and surface finish are of secondary importance. So that are the important criteria here. Non-precision grinding doesn't give the more important to the surface finish. So the rough grinders generally having a three classification. The one is the bench grinder and second one is the swing frame grinder and third one is the abrasive belt grinder. So and second important grinding process, precision grinding. So obviously non-precision grinding doesn't give the importance to the grinding. So obviously precision grinding give the more priority to the surface finish. Precision grinding is the concerned with producing a good surface finishes and accurate dimensions. Three types of precision grinding exist. The first one is the external cylindrical grinding and second one internal cylindrical grinding and third one surface grinding. So these two diagrams representing the precision grinding. The first diagram representing the internal cylindrical grinding. Obviously the second diagram representing the external cylindrical grinding. And grinding wheel. So that is the another type of grinding tool. So consists of a abrasive material or bonding material. Abrasive particles accomplished by the cutting process. Bonding material holds the particles in place and establishes shape and the surface of a wheel structure. So important parameter influenced the cutting wheel, abrasive materials, grind size, bonding material, wheel grade and the wheel structure. So these four parameters playing major role in the cutting wheel. And these three diagrams representing the surface images of a grinding wheel. I mean otherwise called as the microstructural image of a grinding wheel. The first diagram shows the SEM image, scanning electron microscopic images of a cutting wheel. And the second diagram representing the bonding material. So how the abrasive particles are get together. That is the second image exists. And the third image, the red color region representing the micro cracks and the gray color region representing the grind fracture structures. And abrasive material properties. So it should have a high properties such as high hardness, wear resistance, toughness, friability, which means capacity to fracture when cutting edge dulls, so a new sharp edge is exposed. So these are the major properties of abrasive materials. And what are the common abrasive materials available? The first one is the aluminium oxide. So in which aluminium oxide, various substances may be added to enhance hardness, toughness and etc. Plain aluminium oxide is white in nature and used to grind materials like steel, ferrous and high strength alloy. So aluminium oxide only suitable for steel, ferrous materials and high strength alloy materials. And the second abrasive particle, silicon carbide. It is known as the trade as carborundum. Harder than aluminium oxide but not as tough. Used to grind aluminium, brass, stainless steel, cast iron and settle brittle ceramics. And the third one, boron nitride, in forms of single crystal cubic boron nitride, in familiar terms CBN, to use it to grind the materials such as tool steel and aerospace alloys and diamond. So we are familiar to the diamond. It's one of the strongest material, both natural and artificial, used on hard materials such as ceramics, cemented carpets and glass. So diamond abrasive material which is used to grind the materials such as ceramics, cemented carpets and glass. And grind size. So we know the lot of abrasive particles combined together form a one particular grinding wheel, and that grinding wheel having some microstructural and grind sizes. So important parameter in determining the surface finish and material removal rate. Small grit sizes produce better finishes. Larger grit sizes permit the larger material removal rates. Also, harder materials need smaller grind sizes to cut effectively, while softer materials require larger grit size. So in this parameter, we should remember that softer material requires the larger grit size and the harder material requires the smaller grit size. Grind size used in grinding changes between 8 to 250, while 8 is very coarse but 250 is very fine. So 8 is the very smaller grind size which is used to machining the hardened materials. So 250 is the very fine, which means the larger grit size which is used to machining the softer materials. And bonding materials. So what are the bonding materials available? To get wide range of properties needed to grinding wheels, abrasive materials bonded by the using organic or inorganic materials. So inorganic material, vitrified bond, clay bond melted to a porcelain or glass like consistency. It can be made strong and rigid for heavy grinding and not affected by water, oil and acid. Most grinding wheels are having a vitrified bond. So most of the grinding wheels having the vitrified bonds. And second one, silicate bond is essentially hardened by the baking. It holds grinds more loosely than the vitrified bond. Large wheels can be made more easily with the silicate bond, usually used to the situation where the heat generation must be minimized. So where the small amount of heat influences occur, so obviously we move on to the silicate bond. And third one, metallic bond. Cubic boron nitride and diamond abrasives are usually, but not always, embedded in the metallic bond for utmost in a strength and tendency to hold the costly and long wearing grinds. And third one, and the next important bonding type, organic bond, the rubber bond. The first one is the rubber bond. It's a flexible bond used in the cut-off wheels. And second one, resinoid bond. It's a high-strength bond used for rough grinding and cut-off operation. And third one, shellac bond. It's relatively strong but not rigid, used in the application that requires good finishing. And wheel grade and wheel structure. So how the structures are formed? The grade of a grinding wheel is a measure of how strongly the grinds are held by the bond. Typical structure of a grinding wheel contains abrasive grinds, bond material and porous, which means air gaps. And structure. The structure indicates the amount of bond of present between the individual abrasive grinds and the closeness of an individual grind to each other. So structure is clearly defined there. Individual abrasive grinds and which is having the most of the grind each other. And wheel grade and wheel structure, so indicated by the following formula, VG plus VB plus VP equal to 1, which means where VP is the relatively large and VG is the relatively small, it is called open structure. And if VG relatively large and VP is relatively small, it is called dense structure. So also called as a closed structure. And open structures are recommended in situation where the clearance for chip must be provided. Dense structures are used to obtain better surface finish and dimensional control. And the specification of a grinding wheel. So we have four important specifications. The first one is the diameter of a cutting wheel, and second one, bore diameter of a cutting wheel, and third one, thickness of a cutting wheel, and fourth one, type of wheel. So these are the four important specifications of a grinding wheel. And grade. What is grade? The grade indicates the strength of a bond, and therefore the hardness of a wheel in a hard wheel in bond is strong and securely anchors the grid in its place, and therefore reduces the rate of wear in a soft wheel. The bond is weak and the grid is easily detached, resulting in a high rate of wear. That is the grade. The American National Standard Institution, ANSI, marking the system for standard wheels, which means the specification. Prefix. The prefix is the abrasive and type. Abrasive, grind size and grade, structure, bond type, manufacturer, equipment. For example, 51A36L5V3. So the 51 is representing the prefix and A is the abrasive type. 36, abrasive grind size, and the L, grade, and 5, structure, V, bond type, 23, manufacturer record. So that is a signature of a ANSI for the cutting wheel. Prefix. What is prefix? Manufacturer symbol indicating the exact kind of abrasive. Maybe it's aluminium oxide or silicon carbide, something like that. And abrasive type, aluminium oxide, silicon carbide, boron nitride, and a diamond. And grind size. So we have coarse materials like 8 to 24 and medium 30 to 60 and fine 70 to 180. The very fine, which means less than 220. That is a grind size. And grade ranges from A to Z, where A represents the soft and Z represents the hard wheel of the grade. And it starts from A and end with a Z. So A representing the soft material and Z representing the hard wheel grade. And structure. Scale is numeric, very dense and the very open. And the bond type, resin, either resinoid or vitrified. I mean shellac, rubber, silicate and the vitrified. So manufacturer record. So as per the private marking to the identify of the wheel, it is the according to the employee. And selection of a grinding wheel. So how to select one particular grinding wheel? So based on the criteria, the first one, material to be grounded, and next the amount of stack to be removed, and the third one, finished, the fourth one, area of contact, the fifth one, wheel speed, and the sixth one, method of cooling. So these are the important parameters we have to consider while selecting the one particular grinding wheel. And wheel shape and size. We have a different sizes. The first one is the straight cylinders, and second one tapered two side and straight cup, flaring cup, dish and saucer. So these are the different shape of a cutting wheels. Yes, the first diagram representing the straight cutting wheel, and type 2 cylindrical cutting wheel, and third one straight and straight cup, depressed center is a mounted. These are the different shape of a one grinding wheel. And what are the application of a different shaped cutting wheel? Tapered face straight wheel, which is used to grinding the threads and the gear teeth. And cylindrical wheel used to grinding the flat surfaces. And flaring cup wheel used to tool room work, simultaneously grinds the face and root of a tooth. And dish wheel, thinness of a wheel permits it grind the surface in the narrow places like a sheet metal. And wheel wear. So obviously when the particular grinding wheel got in the wear. The overall wear of a bonded abrasive is caused by the three distinct mechanisms. The first one is the atrocious wear, and third one fracture of the grinds and fracture of the bond. So what is the atrocious wear? Sharp edge of an abrasive grind become dull by attrition developing the flat area. So keep on continuously working on one particular grinding wheel, obviously the sharp edges will be get blunt. That is called atrocious wear. And fraction of a grind. Portion of the grind breaks off. The fractured area becomes new cutting area. So obviously, the more heat will be produced due to the friction between the workpiece surface, the grinding wheel surface, the grinding wheel may be broke. The broken area acts as a one cutting edge. That is called fracture of a grind. And the third one, fraction of the bond. Part of the grinds fall out. And wheel dressing, which means how to improve the cutting edge of a grinding wheel by using the wheel dressing. And this diagram clearly representing the how to improve the cutting edge by using the wheel dressing. and what is dressing and what is turing. Dressing removes loading and breaks away the glassed surface so that sharp abrasive particles are again presented to the work. What is turing? It is the process of changing the shape of a grinding wheel as it becomes warm from one original shape owing to the breaking away of a bond. That is turing. And grain action. The first one is the cutting, plowing and rubbing. What is cutting? Grit can penetrate to the surface and actually perform chip removing. That is called cutting. So what is plowing? Grits can be penetrate to the surface, not far and enough to cut, but cannot perform cutting. The work surface deforms. And rubbing, grit contacts to the surface, energy consumed without cutting. So, and both plowing and rubbing purely depends on the cutting. And specification of a grinding machine. So, one particular grinding machine having the specification such as distance between table and the middle of a spindle up to 400 mm. So, it should have a exactly 400 mm. And grinding wheel maximum diameter into width. In smaller diameters are 225 into 51 mm. So, that is the grinding wheel dimensions. And size of a magnet 400 into 150 mm in representing the length and the width. And size of a table 400 into 150 mm. And motor power, it's a 2 kilowatt motor. So that particular grinding machine, however, these five specifications must be. And the first type of grinder, surface grinder. So we can able to improve the surface finish by using the surface grinder. Thus, this machine may be similar to the milling machine used in the mainly grind the flat surfaces. So obviously, surface grinders only applicable for grinding the flat surface. However, some types of surface grinders are also capable to producing the contour surface without form the grinding wheel. So, what are the types of surface grinders? Horizontal spindling reciprocating table, horizontal spindling rotary table, vertical spindling reciprocating table, vertical spindling rotary table. With respect to the horizontal and vertical vice versa. And this diagram representing the surface grinding. So, what are the major components? Wheel head, column, bed, feed, saddle, workpiece, work table and the work guard. And my workpiece will be located on the work table with the application of magnetic purpose. And the wheel guard which is used to is mainly focused on the safety purpose. And the vertical type of grinding, clearly the entire grinding setup in direction of a vertical. The machine setup will be, the entire motion will be in the vertical direction, so that is called as a vertical type. Obviously in the horizontal cylindrical grinding, the machine is used to produce the external cylindrical surface. The surface may be straight, tapered, stitched or profiled. Broadly, these are three different types of cylindrical grinding machine as follows. So what are the types of cylindrical grinding? Plane center type cylindrical grinder, universal cylindrical grinder, which is used to swilling wheel head, swilling wheel head slide, swilling head stock. And the third one is centerless cylindrical surface grinder. The familiar surface cylindrical grinder is the centerless cylindrical surface grinder. Yes, centerless grinding. It is undesirable to fix the workpiece every time between the centers. So work is not supported between the centers. The work is supported on the rest blade and the regulating wheel holds the workpiece, which means centerless grinding. So we never setting the center of a cutting wheel. So we can able to grind any in any region of the surface of a flat workpieces. And what are the advantages of a grinding wheel? Rate of production is more than the cylindrical grinding. Work is supported rigidly along the whole length, suitable for a long jobs. Due to the floating condition, centering is eliminated and time is not wasted centering. So applicable for centerless grinding. Doesn't require the center holes, drivers and other work holding fixtures. These are the advantages. And so in this presentation itself, we will discussed and we learned. So what is grinding? What is abrasive machining and different types of grinding? What is grit size? What is structure of a cutting wheel? What are the abrasive particles and such things we will discuss. So we all discussed. I hope you all understood. Thank you.